Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Lukmaan IAS. This is DTRS session, Daily Takkar Rapid Series. What we are doing in this lecture series, daily we are discussing 10 quality MCQs which are related to today's current affairs. So this is class 81 now, and the lead topic for today. See, this is not the only topic we are going to discuss. The first MCQ will be discussed on this topic, and then there are 9 MCQs on 9 different important topics for today. Rashtriya Vigyan Puraskar. So yes, the government has come up with the new kind of awards for scientific community in the country, Rashtriya Vigyan Puraskar, and yes, Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar Prize is also subsumed under this. Good evening, everyone, online students. Let's talk about these MCQs, but before that, let's discuss one quotation. Daily, we are discussing one quotation which is helping us to improve our essay as well as ethics paper. Right, so today's quotation, once made equal to man, woman becomes his superior. Socrates, Greek philosopher. Okay, so let's try to understand this and why we are discussing this context. Current mein aapko pata hai, women's reservation bill has been passed, 33% reservation in the parliament, and we can say that in the state assembly also. And along with that, you can see this year's essay paper. There was this question related to the society angle, the demands from the men that society is having and the restrictions on the women. So, usse related jo hai problems, uske baare mein ek essay topic tha. There was this question even in ethics paper talking about the socialization and we can say overall women's issues. So, once made equal to man, women becomes his superior. So, we have to understand this aspect. How? So at present, we know that there are inherent inequalities in the society. Okay, inequalities in terms of how the women are subordinated, not only in the, we can say at the family level, but at societal level, and even in the organizations, we see the problems like glass ceiling effect and all these things. So there are inherent inequalities, but once they are made equal to men, okay, so that means, let's say women are kept at par with the men, like for example, even through affirmative actions, then thereafter, the woman becomes his superior. How this happens? Let's try to understand this. Why he is trying to tell in this manner is because women is women are having certain traits, or we can say that different values, traits, which are having some advantages over the men. Kis tarike se hum bol sakte hai yahan par? Like for example, very high level of emotional intelligence. So they are able to manage their emotions very effectively, and that helps them to effective decision making. देखिए जो आप YouTube पे या फिर Instagram पे जो reels देखते हैं कि women are not empowered, women cannot drive. ठीक है, तो वो आप देखते हैं कि कोई लड़की ड्राइव कर रही है तो उसको मजाक उड़ाते हुए जो रील्स और वो सब चीजें बनती है, दैट इज नॉट रियलिटी, राइट? ऑफ कोर्स वी आर अवेयर अबाउट दैट. व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट दिस, वी आर टॉकिंग हियर अबाउट वेदर वुमेन आर एबल टू लीड द टीम, वेदर वुमेन आर एबल टू जस्टिफाई द पोजिशन दे आर होल्डिंग इन टर्म्स ऑफ अप्रोप्रिएट डिसीजन मेकिंग एंड लीडिंग द टीम. सो वी आर टॉकिंग फ्रॉम दिस एंगल, दिस ट्रेड्स. So emotional intelligence is there, then along with that certain values, especially love, care, compassion. Now these values not only are reflected in the family level or personal level, but also in the public sphere. And these values are very important also. Okay, so the compassionate angle, or we can say the care aspect, this is very important. And when they are made equal to men, we are aware that these values, human values, are very important. Especially nowadays, we see the kind of violence or conflicts that are happening around the world. If the women are, let's say, the decision maker, they will prefer these values over the conflict, violence, and we can say that other negative values. Okay, so this is for sure, and these will have long-lasting impact, these values, in the decision making. We have already discussed such kind of topics. ठीक है, जो गांधी जी का कोटेशन है, the I आई फॉर आई कैन मेक होल वर्ल्ड ब्लाइंड, या फिर कोई भी जो वॉर हो रहा है तो वहाँ पे कॉन्फ्लिक्ट वायलेंस से ज़्यादा इफेक्टिव लव और कंपैशन, ये वैल्यूज ज़्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है लॉन्ग लास्टिंग पीस के लिए, राइट? सो वी कैन से दैट दिस इज हाउ दे कैन बिकम द सुपेरियर. इन एडिशन टू दैट ऑफकोर्स दे आर हैविंग द इंडिविजुअल एप्टीट्यूड, ठीक है, एप्टीट्यूड इज इनबॉर्न, राइट, एंड इट कैन बी अमंग द मेन एज वेल एज वुमेन स्पेसिफिक टू. ऐसा कोई होता नहीं कि मेन आर हैविंग मोर लेट्स से सुपीरियर एप्टीट्यूड एज कम्पेयर टू वुमेन, तो वो तो इनबॉर्न होता है. एंड इन एडिशन टू दैट दे हैव नो पॉजिटिव एटीट्यूड इन टर्म्स ऑफ वी कैन से दैट लेट्स से कंपैशनेट एटीट्यूड और वी कैन से पॉजिटिव ऑप्टिमिस्टिक एटीट्यूड, ऑल दीज थिंग्स कैन बी टॉक्ड वी कैन से फ्रॉम दिस एंगल. सो वैल्यूज एंड ट्रेड्स, दैट्स वाई सुपीरियर. ओके, वन कैन डिस्कस लाइक दिस, ये इंटरप्रिटेशन इस तरीके से हो सकता है इसका. फाइन, ओके, लेट्स टॉक अबाउट नाउ टुडेज 10 एमसीक्यूज. दीज आर द टॉपिक्स, लेट्स गो इन डिटेल वन बाय वन. फर्स्ट, व्हाट शुड बी आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन, क्या होना चाहिए इसका आंसर? यस, ऑनलाइन स्टूडेंट्स गिव योर आंसर्स इन द कमेंट बॉक्स. राष्ट्रीय विज्ञान पुरस्कार, दीज वेर इन न्यूज. द अवार्ड शैल बी गिवन इन थ्री कैटेगरीज, नेमली विज्ञान रत्न, विज्ञान श्री, एंड वी कैन से दैट विज्ञान युवा. नाउ इन एडिशन टू दीज थ्री देर इज ऑल्सो वी कैन से दैट टीम विज्ञान, विज्ञान टीम, दिस इज द फोर्थ वन. सो देर आर टोटल फोर कैटेगरीज, ये थ्री फैक्चुअली इनकरेक्ट है. And second one, Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar Award has been subsumed in one of the above mentioned categories. This is true. First one is incorrect. It is subsumed under which category? Vigyan Yuva. It is subsumed under Vigyan Yuva. Then scientist, technologist, and innovator working in only government organization. Now only extreme statement, we can say that even those working the let's say scientist and technologist working in the private institutions can also apply for this particular award, and that's why this becomes incorrect statement. So only one, that is A, is the correct answer for this question. Okay, let's talk about now next question. What should be answer to this question? Very simple one. With reference to India's biodiversity, look at the PYQ. The names are given and we have to identify species to which it belongs. So it is talking about gurnards and guppy. Gurnards and guppy, the new species of fish, gurnard fish, we can say fish species have been found in Bay of Bengal, we can say in the West Bengal coastal region. So basically it is species of fish. Okay, remember this. Now gurnards basically group of marine species. Theek hai, ye hai marine species. They are found in deep sea, not shallow waters, continental slope, and we can say deep sea, and they are carnivores. They are eating the other, we can say small fish, and we can say that crustaceans. So remember this aspect. They are asking such questions on the species from environment section. So B is the correct answer here. All right. Now next question. Okay. So it is talking about the rhino species. So already in past we have discussed few questions related to rhino. So World Rhino Day will be celebrated. So that's why it is in news. Rhino, there are total 5 species of rhinos in the world at present, and they have different conservation status, IUCN conservation status, and accordingly we'll see this question. Javan rhino is the largest of the rhino species. Now this is not correct, because Indian rhino, that is great, we can say that greater one horn rhino, we can say it is the largest in terms of size. So this is not correct. India has all 5 species of rhino. Now this is also not true. Only we have Indian rhino, that is greater one horn rhino species in India. The other species like this Javan and Sumatran rhinos, they are found in Southeast Asia region. Javan and Sumatran rhinos, both are critically endangered. Then other two are from Africa, black rhinos and white rhinos. So black rhino is again, we can say that critically endangered, while white rhino near threatened. It is near threatened. And this, the Indian rhino, it is having status of vulnerable. It is the status of vulnerable. Okay, fine. So what should be the answer here? Both statements are incorrect, so D is the correct answer. All right, let's talk about now next question. Again, the mapping part is asked here. What should be the answer? Yes, Vijay, kya hona chahiye iska answer? Consider the following countries. How many of the above do not border with Black Sea? Theek hai, do not border bola hua hai. We can miss this, and that's why you should be carefully reading the statement, question statement. Ukraine is pretty straightforward. Romania, we are also, then again south of it, Georgia. Syria is not part of that region, we can say, though this is not having border with Black Sea, we can say. And that's why only one, that is A, is the correct answer here. Black Sea is continuously in news. Already UPC has asked question regarding the locations in the Ukraine, like Kherson region, Zaporizhia. So we can expect in future also such kind of questions. Now, recently the both houses of the parliament, we can say adjournment sine die, this was announced. Okay, adjournment sine die is basically ends the parliamentary sitting for an indefinite period. This is true. There are four things that you should keep in mind: summoning, adjournment sine die, and prorogation. Very simple that you should keep in mind: summon and prorogation both are by president. Okay, basically it is summoning the session and prorogation of session, so that's why it is by president, right? Adjournment and adjournment sine die is by presiding officer. Presiding officer. So for Lok Sabha, it is speaker. For Rajya Sabha, it is the chairman. Right? So here you should know the meaning also. Adjournment is for day sitting. Okay. So Lok Sabha is adjourned for the day. This is how presiding officer speaker will say. Adjournment sine die is for indefinite. Adjournment for indefinite time period. ठीक है, तो इनडेफिनाइट टाइम पीरियड जो होता है उसमें कोई डेट या कोई चीज मेंशन नहीं होती है, दैट वी विल रीअसेंबल ऑन मंडे, लेट्स से ऑन फ्राइडे दे आर सेइंग दैट वी विल रीअसेंबल ऑन मंडे. इन एडजर्नमेंट इट इज सेड लाइक दिस. इन एडजर्नमेंट सिने डाय देयर इज नो मेंशन ऑफ रीअसेंबली, इट्स टाइम और डेट, दैट्स व्हाई वी कॉल इट एज इनडेफिनाइट टाइम पीरियड. Generally, before prorogation, the presiding officer will declare adjournment sine die, and thereafter, after some days, the president will say that the session is prorogued. Very simple. The power of adjournment as well as adjournment sine die lies with the president of India. It is incorrect. First one is correct. Speaker can call a sitting of Lok Sabha at any time after the house has been adjourned sine die. Again, it is yes, we can say it is correct. Why? Any time, it's not specific time. It is not specific time. So two statements are correct here. B is the correct answer. Fine. Okay, now let's talk about next question. Iska answer kya hona chahiye? Assam Rifles. So in past, recently, this year only, they have asked about home guards forces. They are asking about forces. So we should be ready with other CAPFs also, and all the forces, central government, central forces, we can say. Assam Rifles is one of the, we can say, border guarding forces, which border it is guarding Myanmar, with Myanmar.
Right. So in Northeast India, Assam Rifle is having prominent presence, and at present, whatever the violence that is going on in Manipur, it is being largely dealt by Assam Rifles. Like the uniqueness of Assam is that it is one of the CAPF that is having, we can say, operational control by the Indian Army, but overall administration comes under Ministry of Home Affairs. So dual control is there. Okay, so uniqueness is this one. It is incorrect statement. It was originally raised during the British period to protect the tea gardens. Now this is true. The origin lies in this. So protecting the against illegal trespassers into the tea gardens, this was the original motive, and thereafter, after independence, this was let's say converted into one of the CAPF. It is the oldest paramilitary force in India, formed even before the 1857 War of Independence. This is also true. Before 1857, it is formed. So two statements are correct here. Again, we can say that. So remember, it can be asked in the mains examination as well as prelims examination. So next question. Yes, CAQM, Commission for Air Quality Management. Yes, it is in news. Why? Because now Delhi air pollution, as the Diwali will come near, so all these things will be continuously in news. Then the stubble burning and all these things. Now, Commission for Air Quality Management, this particular statutory body. It is a statutory body established under CAQM Act 2021. Okay, there was actually earlier ordinance, thereafter there was act, okay, enacted by the parliament. So we can say it is incorrect because it is saying executive body. It is incorrect. Commission can take up the matter suo moto. Now this is true. It can take the issues related to pollution or matters related to pollution, especially in Delhi and NCR region, suo moto. The powers of commission are subordinate to that of CPCB. Now this is incorrect. It is having rather overriding powers. It is having overriding powers over CPCB as well as SPCB, State Pollution Control Boards. Okay, CPCB as well as SPCB. So this is very important. And commission works in full coordination with the Supreme Court appointed EPA. Rather, this is incorrect. No, we know that it has replaced the Supreme Court appointed EPCA. So this is incorrect statement. So only one is the correct answer here, right? A is the correct answer, Vijay. Okay, fine. Now let's talk about next question. Committee of Privileges. So again, there is problem going on in Lok Sabha, some comments by some MPs, and the Privileges Committee is in news. Let's talk about this. The committee consists of 15 members in Lok Sabha and same in case of Rajya Sabha. No, this is incorrect. Not same, rather there are 10 members in case of Lok Sabha. This is incorrect. The deputy chairperson heads the Committee of Privileges in Rajya Sabha. Now this is correct. Okay. The committee examines every question involving breach of privilege. Of course, it is generic, the function aspect. The parliamentary privileges were codified under the law in year 2022 only. So this is again incorrect. At present, we don't have, we can say, codified privileges, parliamentary privileges. Still, we are following, let's say, some of the articles that are mentioned, the provisions, and along with that, parliamentary conventions. Okay, parliamentary conventions, important source for parliamentary privileges, and accordingly the committee decides. Okay, so two statements are correct here, two incorrect, so B is the correct answer, right? All right, ninth question. What should be answer to this one? Yes, what it is saying, Attorney General. Attorney General can bring motion in the parliament before the Supreme Court initiate a case of criminal contempt. Okay, so what it is saying, Attorney General can bring a motion. Now you tell me that Attorney General is having similar privileges to, we can say, that MPs, those MPs which are sitting in the parliamentary houses. That's why we can say in India, Supreme Court and High Court have the power to try and punish the contempt. We know that. Now, Attorney General or Solicitor General can bring a motion before the Supreme Court to initiate a case of criminal contempt. ठीक है, तो ये जो Parliament लिखा हुआ है, this is not correct. first statement should be incorrect here.
ठीक है, this is incorrect.
Now, the contempt proceedings can be initiated by the court itself. Yes, suo moto, it can initiate the contempt of court. We can say proceedings. A subordinate court can only make reference to the high court for initiating contempt proceedings. This is true because contempt powers are at present given to high court as well as supreme court and not subordinate courts. So what should be the answer here? Two are correct here. Parliament mein attorney general motion nahi la sakta, wo MPs hi la sakta hai. Yes, attorney general can bring the motion in front of or before the supreme court. Theek hai, to ye statement mein changes karne ki zarurat hai. We can consider this as a B. Okay, B is the correct answer here. Now let's talk about next one. World's largest cement producer is China. Best quality cement is exported by Russia. So yes, generally ye dekhna hai hame ki China is the we can say in terms of economy it is one of the fastest growing, along with that larger in terms of population, so its demand for cement will be more. So this is true. The best quality cement is exported by Russia. Now this is not true. Best quality cement is exported by China, Germany, theek hai, aise countries jo hai, not Russia. Remember this. So this is incorrect. The world's largest cement exporter, USA, not correct. Again, rather we can say that it is Vietnam. One can get confused here. Even this Southeast Asian country is the largest, we can say, exporter. Theek hai? Yes. So how many statements are correct here? Only one statement is correct. In terms of India, India is the second largest producer as well as consumer after China. Producer as well as consumer after China. ठीक है, so A is the correct answer for this one. All right, okay, so these are today's 10 MCQs. Any question related to these? All right, yes, it's Vietnam. ठीक है, Vietnam is having the largest export of cement. Okay, fine, then let us stop. Okay.